Monday afternoon, we're down here at the Cell in Faversham. Just watch Sean Kennedy and Chris Gearing in training. They're training up for their respective UK Strongest Man competitions. Chris, of course, doing the Open. Sean doing the 105. Boys, how did you go today, Chris?
Yeah, it was a good one today. Got a bit of the cobwebs out and had a little run around and got a bit sweaty and that. So, yeah, it was good, mate. It was a good little session. Get us back on track.
Enjoyed that. And you, Sean, as well?
Yeah, it was good. I've just been ill, so... I'm all right. Yeah, I had a cold and I'd come down. I didn't think I'd do anything, but yeah, I had a good day.
Had a good one. And you both actually had a couple of weeks off, didn't you? Off of training and everything else. I mean, does it help you when you have a couple of weeks off, Chris? Do you come back feeling stronger? I know you've been a bit under the weather with that as well. It wasn't a plan 2 weeks off, was it? It's fair to say.
Yeah, I mean, I think you don't lose anything. I think it's more mentally where you haven't been training that you're sort of like, oh, I don't know if I can pick this up. I don't know if I can pick that up. I think you still got it in your body, but it's just in your head. So you just need to take it back a little bit, get back in the groove of things and start again as such. But you're still as strong, but it's all in your head, isn't it?
Of course it is. And you've done a lot of competitions, Chris, all in a row, didn't you?
Yeah.
I mean, you've done... Talk us through your competitions, your sort of what you've done.
I started off a Southern Qualifier at Rob Frampton's of Strength Tech. Then I done a couple of weeks off and then it was England's Strongest Man, I think. Then Britain's Strongest Man. I went out to Hungary to compete out there as well. Which I come fifth at the Giants Live out there. So all the comps I've done have been a lot of comps.
Yeah, come third at Britain's Strongest Man as well, mate. Yeah. Got to mention that.
Yeah, third at Britain's Strongest Man was good. Obviously, the events got cut and everything else, but it was good. I pulled 400 kilos as well. So I was really happy with that. Bit unexpected as such.
So you're on the back of some really good performances. I know you was a bit disappointed with Hungary, Chris. I mean, a couple of things went wrong for you out there. Do you want to talk to us about that?
Yeah, I mean, a couple of events went good, were all right. Sort of like the Viking press and the truck pull, that was all right. I won the deadlift, I won the yoke, mucked up the weight for height, I'd never done it, so that was a bit of a...
Hadn't you got that in practice before?
Yeah, on the warm-up, I threw it straight over and then couldn't do it in the comp, so...
Jack Mack was telling me about it, couldn't believe it.
So, it's just timing, that's a timing event, so where I've never thrown that before, my timing was just useless, wasn't it, really, let's be honest, but...
It happens, mate.
And then the barrels... Well, barrels are barrels, one went straight over the back, which happens, so...
Threw it too hard.
Maybe.
Bit too keen?
Maybe. Lack of experience, I think, as well, slightly. And maybe got myself a bit up the wall because it was a bit of a pressure comp. Everyone's talking about going World's Strongest Man, this, that, the other. You know what I mean? I've gone from watching them boys on the telly to mixing it with them. So I think it was a number of things, but I live and learn.
And it is all about learning at the minute, mate.
Yeah, everything. I've come from nowhere to somewhere as such in a short time of space. So it's all right. It's done now, isn't it?
Yeah, I think there's a lot of people proud of you, Chris, and onwards and upwards you go, mate.
Yeah, I've made my family proud, my training partner proud, so that's all I really care about. I'm not really bothered about anyone else. So
are you proud of him, Sean?
Yeah, he's done well, hasn't he? He has done well. Just all goes wrong for me and goes right for him. I'll get fed out of it.
No, yeah, do you know what? You do suffer with your injuries, Sean. You've done all right this time, you know?
It went the other way this year. We had a good week, a good comp towards the end of the season, and now we're getting ready for UKs. And it all went wrong at the start of the season. So I thought my year was going to be written off, but you knew that anyway, you know? It's just England's most powerful man happened. Come second.
Done really well.
Yeah. I've done everything I wanted to do and better. I wanted to go in there and I wanted to qualify for UKs. I come second, I've done that. I beat Ben Kelsey on the log, which was the game as well. I'm strong at shoulders. I wanted to beat him on the log. I had to go and win that event, you know, and I did. But then everything else, he's the next step, you know. Paul Wood was that next step. He's the next step. He's world class. So now I've just got to chase him. UK's is coming, you know. I mean, someone, he can pull 350 kilos, 105.
It's phenomenal, isn't it?
Well, there's me screaming, I'll pull 300 kilos, going, yeah, I think it's a brilliant lift. He walks out and pulls 350. I mean, Chris pulled 350 last year in the garden at the Halloween comp, and that was a good lift for him last year. And he's
now 105s are doing it.
What's that about? You know what I mean?
It's brilliant. It's super. It just keeps going up and up. And the quality's getting better and better. The athletes are getting better, you know. And it's just getting better. That's all I can say.
It just makes you keep training harder, doesn't it?
Of course it does. And it gives you something to aim at as well.
Yeah, I just, you know, I wish I was the one that was, you know, the one that everyone was chasing. But, you know, you got to put the hard work in. Don't get me wrong, we are working hard. It just... it seems that you go three steps forward, one step back, three steps forward, one step back. So, you know, you just got to keep
plugging away.
I'm the sort of person, I'll get frustrated, you know. I do that three step forward, one step back, and then I'm walking around punching myself in here because I've got the upper back.
With your head down.
Yeah, just, you know, you can't do that. You've got to swallow it. You swallow it, go back to next, you know, if you have a bad training session, go back the next week, do it again, you know.
Training session is still a training session. I heard someone say that, and you've got to get through it, you know. So talk us through what you've done today, Chris. What was it all about today? What did we start off with?
Started off with Axel, just getting the reps back in, done like reps of five on things, so that was good. Just getting the pressing back going again. Then we done a Yoke Farmers Medley, six reps, sorry, on one set, and five on the other, to be precise, if that's what you want.
Want to be finicky.
Yeah. And then we done Yoke and Farmers together, have a run around with that, and then little throwing the barrels up. So just sort of, just maintaining really, just to see where we're at, because we've both been off, we've both had a little break and that.
As you said, blowing the cobwebs out.
Yeah, blowing the cobwebs out, really, just see where we're at, and then we know, get this week out of the way of getting back loose again and aching a little bit, and we'll start, it'll be all right.
Okay, boys, good luck for your respective competitions. Very Thanks much. For having me, Danny, boys.
Cheers.
Good luck.
Cheers, mate.
Fast, Chris.